Reimagining Chapel. We've been talking about the stories of courageous people, and our UU of the week definitely fits that description. Courageous people often face difficult and dangerous situations that unfortunately do not always end happily, as is the case with this week's UU of the week. James Reeb was born in Kansas in 1927. He was not a healthy child and had severe vision issues that were not able to be corrected until he was in high school. Due to his father's work, the family moved throughout the South and the West. Finishing high school in Casper, Wyoming, James loved football, debate, and social justice. He saw the needs of the people in his community and wanted to create a more economically just society where no one's human rights were denied. James's family attended several different Christian churches in his youth. Every time they moved, they found a new church. By the end of high school, he was pulled with his faith and desire to create a more just world to start Presbyterian ministry. While he deeply desired to enter theological school, when James graduated in 1945, the United States was still at the tail end of World War II. James joined the Army and served in Anchorage, Alaska. After the Army, James returned home to Casper, Wyoming to attend junior college. From there, he transferred to St. Olaf College in Minnesota. James married Marie Deason on the summer of 1950. James entered Princeton Theological Seminary and was ordained in 1953. He became a hospital chaplain and began to be deeply involved in pastoral counseling. To become even more advanced, he actually enrolled in another master's program to receive a pastoral counseling degree. It was around this time that James's faith evolved. He began to see the world through a more liberal, humanist, religious lens. Presbyterianism was no longer where he saw his future in the ministry. Through a series of lectures and a well-read religious education text written by Sophia Lyon Foss, he realized he was actually Unitarian. He resigned his Presbyterian ministry and began working with the American Unitarian Association to become ordained. James began his work right away, immediately starting to work with the economically disenfranchised in Philadelphia. When he was able, he moved with his family to Washington, D.C. to begin work at All Souls Church as an assistant minister. Never one to shy away from hard conversations, James moved his ministry outside the walls of the church to the larger community, working with outside groups to address social problems in the Washington, D.C. area. Due to his position as assistant minister, James didn't do a lot of preaching. James wanted a pulpit of his own in a racially diverse community, working towards justice and care for one another. Unfortunately, no such congregation existed. James decided to take a position in Boston at a low-income housing group. The family moved to Roxbury, a black community in Boston. His daughter remembers him being adamant that the family could not live a segregated life and still make a difference in the lives of those that they served. The Reeb family joined the Arlington Street Church in Boston, and James met Jack Mendelson, the congregation's social activist minister. Maintaining his ministry, James joined the UUA, the Unitarian Universalist Association's Commission on Religion and Race, created by another UU of the week, Homer Jack. The country was in the throes of the 1960s civil rights movement. After a day of police brutality against 500 protesters marching from Selma to Montgomery in Alabama, the UUA received a telegram from Dr. Martin Luther King asking ministers and people of faith to join the marchers in Selma. Always one to side with justice, James had to go to Alabama against his wife's real concerns for his safety. He joined over 2,500 marchers in Selma. That evening, James had dinner with two colleagues in a predominantly black neighborhood. As they were driving home, their car was attacked by white men shouting awful racial epithets at them. While everyone in the car was injured, James received a severe blow to the head. At the time, there were no neurosurgeons in Montgomery, and an ambulance had to transfer him to Birmingham, 90 miles away. 2 days later, he died. James Reeb's death became an unfortunate lightning bolt to the movement. His funeral, held at Brown Chapel in Selma, was attended by an enormous crowd. The president of the UUA offered prayers, and Dr. King gave the eulogy, saying, quote, "He was a witness to the truth that men of different races and classes might live, eat, and work together as brothers." On the evening of the funeral, President Lyndon B. Johnson spoke to a joint session of Congress proposing the Voting Rights Act. Later that summer, after a lengthy debate and discord, the law was passed. James Reeb lived his life with an eye towards justice and faith. His memory lives on as a courageous person who gave his life for the fight for equality.